Hi everyone, Christina from Interlaced here. As some of you may know, last week we were supposed to host our first event for the year with Lone Design Club on Who Fashion Forgets. Sadly, due to the escalating coronavirus health concerns, we decided to postpone that until the 23rd of April. So between then and now, I'm going to be sharing a few videos with you, each focused on a different segment of that event that hopefully will give you an overview of what we're going to cover with our amazing panel on the 23rd of April. And so if you don't have a ticket, you can still get yours. And if you do, then please keep hold of it because it will be valid for the new date. Okay, so first we are starting with adaptive fashion today. If beauty is in the eye of the beholder, and the beholder is actually the fashion industry, I think you'll agree that for the longest time, fashion has been, beauty for the fashion industry has usually materialized and looked like an army of young, white, and kind of privileged girls, skinny girls. That has been, not just when we talk about the runways and who walks during fashion week, but also when it comes to brands creating products and services for people. And notoriously, in an interview with Salon Magazine a few years ago, the former CEO of Abercrombie and Fitch said, there are certain people that don't belong in our clothes and they will never belong. Are we exclusive? Absolutely. Now, it's mind-blowing to me how someone from a clothing company says that, and fair enough, that interview backfired. But it just went on to show how exclusive and still how kind of bad the fashion industry was at making people feel that like they belong. But even though not a lot has changed since then, we have started seeing some brands that really, really embrace creating clothes for people that they would usually not be able to kind of see or even fit in, especially when it comes to people with disabilities or special needs. So one example is retail giant Target, for example. A few years ago, they introduced a special children's wear line that was specifically designed with children with disabilities, and they were praised by the media, the industry, and the public for doing so. After that initial collection, they actually built upon that line to include clothes specifically designed with adult men and women in mind that again had special needs and disabilities. And another kind of champion of inclusivity and adaptive fashion is Tommy Hilfiger. They worked with Universal Thread, which is a non-profit organization, to create the children's wear line for children with special needs, and also a after that, they built upon that similarly to Target, where they included menswear and womenswear as well products, and they featured modified details such as magnetic buttons, adjustable hems, bungee cords, and Velcro brand closures. After that, Tommy Hilfiger partnered with notable figures in this community to start its marketing campaign, including Paralympian gold medal track star Jeremy Campbell, motivational speaker Malik Haks, and a few others as well. So this is not a one-off stunt. It's a continuous effort to build upon something that the brand really believes in and sees the market and sees the market potential as well, actually, because the disability market commands a spending of more than $8 trillion, according to a 2016 report by research firm Return on Disability. Now, that is a huge economic potential for brands that a lot of companies are not addressing at all. So it's something to definitely think about. And just to show you how Tommy, as a prime example, is thinking about that beyond just creating the Tommy Adaptive line and including people from those communities to start in its marketing campaign and collaborating with others to do that line. The company also did is they launched most recently a voice skill for Amazon Alexa. Let me try and share that with you to see how it looks. Yeah, this is how it looks. So to make it even easier for people to navigate their choices, Tommy Hilfiger launched a skill for Amazon Alexa that lets you navigate your options. So if you say, "Hey Alexa, open Tommy Adaptive," then you would be able to navigate your choices based on your state. And then after that, Alexa would also be able to send your preferred options over email, where you could continue to browse the entire collection. So again, this is just one example, or two examples, including Target, of how brands are starting to address that entire segment of people who, for the longest time, haven't felt included. Or if they have, it was because someone created a product or a service that it is for people with special needs and disabilities, but doesn't actually feel fashionable. And this is one of the places that fashion brands specifically have an incredible opportunity to make people empowered and feel good, because that's also what is the prime function of clothes, is to make us feel great, make us feel good and empowered, and that we can go on about our day and we can do better. So those will be just some points that we will be discussing during our event Who Fashion Forgets, with a panel of industry experts from design, marketing, product development. So I hope you will join us. And if you don't have a ticket, as we mentioned, you can get your tickets for the event, which will now be on 23rd of April, at lonedesignclub.com and also Eventbrite. And of course, if you need more information, please feel free to follow us. Interlaced is at We Are Interlaced on all social channels, and Lone Design Club at Lone Design Club as well on all channels. And we will see you very, very soon. We hope you're keeping safe and staying at home as much as you can. And we shall see you soon. Bye.